Good evening. It's Thursday, the 18th of February, 1954, and this is the news. Sir Ronald Weeks, Chairman of the National Advisory Council on Education for Industry and Commerce, today officially opens the new Carlisle Technical College. Whilst work started more than 4 years ago, the first plans for a new technical college for Carlisle were made in 1939, but the outbreak of the war hindered progress. Prior to this, evening classes were held at the city's Tully House. The new state-of-the-art building contains the finest laboratories, workshops, drawing rooms and classrooms. The Technical College will offer a range of subjects from banking, domestic cookery, livestock husbandry, concrete technology and new courses for the more modern persons such as radio and television servicing, typewriting and telecommunications. The college principal, Frank Gardner, says that plans are already in place for a second building featuring a hall, gymnasium and teaching kitchen.
Went down in Louisiana, close to New Orleans. Went back up in the woods among the evergreens. Stood a log cabin made of earth and wood. We lived a country boy named Johnny B. Good. Never ever learned to read or write so well, but he could play the guitar just like a ringing a bell. Go, 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 Johnny, go, go. Go, Johnny, go, go. Go, Johnny, go, go. Go, Johnny, go, go. Johnny B. Good. He used to carry his guitar in a gunny sack. By the railroad track, the engineers used to see him sitting in the shade, strumming to the rhythm that the drivers made. People passing by would stop and see. Oh my.
In other news, a performance celebrating the diamond anniversary of Carlisle College took place tonight in the brand new Carlisle College of the Arts Theatre. It's been 60 years, and the college continues to thrive.